Welcome to the fascinating world of the genes with Rohini, and today we are going to learn about a translational control, a topic from the eukaryotic gene expression. The example that we are going to study, it is of the GCN4, which is a transcriptional activator from the yeast. And this transcriptional activator GCN4, it is involved into the synthesis of the amino acids. So, the GCN4 translation, it will be there when the concentration of the amino acids in the cell, it is lower one. So, that is whenever there are a star condition, whenever there is a lower concentration of the amino acids in the cell, at that time the GCN4, it will be translated. Okay, and when the amino acid concentration, it is higher into the cell, that is when there is abundant of the amino acids, when there are the non-star conditions, at that time the GCN4, it will not be translated. Okay, here you should remember that in the cell there will be the synthesis of the GCN4 mRNA, that is there will be the transcription from the gene of the GCN4. Thus the mRNA of the GCN4, it will be present into the cell, but here there will be the decision making that that mRNA, it has to go for the translation or it don't have to go for the translation. And this it is going to be decided according to the environmental condition, and that environmental condition here, it is the concentration of the amino acid, that is the star and the non-star conditions for the amino acids. So when there is a high concentration of the amino acids, no translation. When there is the low concentration of the amino acid, there will be the translation of the GCN4. Now, before going towards the actual mechanism for the translational control, here you have to learn something about the GCN4 mRNA. In the GCN4 mRNA, there are the open reading frame and they are the upstream open reading frame. U stands for the upstream. And how many they are of the four? ORF1, ORF2, then there is ORF3, ORF4. And then after the ORF4, actual GCN4, okay, actual GCN4 coding region, it is present. The open reading frame for the GCN4, it is after the ORF4. And here, as it is a ORF, each and every ORF, it has its own start codon and it has its own stop codon. Here, when this mRNA, it will go for the translation, at that time, the first translation, it will be done and it will be for the ORF1. Okay, it will be done for the ORF1. It has what? It has a start codon. And now here, what will happen? That your 40S subunit, okay, the 40S subunit with whom? With the charged tRNA, with the EIF2, okay, it is going to be located at the P site. And after this complete 43S complex formation, this 43S complex, now it will scan for whom? It will scan for the AUG codon, that is the start codon. And after scanning, when it will get, okay, when it will get the AUG codon, after that there will be the start of whom? Then there will be the start of the translation, that is here 60S subunit, it is going to bound it, and then there will be the translation. And this translation, it will go up to the termination, okay, in the ORF1. There is a start codon, translation has been started and it will get terminated. There will be the termination of the translation at where? At the stop codon. Here one thing very particular about this, it is what? After the termination, okay, after the termination, here when this ribosome, now it will going at the stop codon, and when there is a dissociation of all the subunits, that is the 60S, it will dissociate, tRNA, it is getting dissociated, peptide, it is going to be dissociated. But here, this 40S, okay, this 40S subunit of the ribosome, it is getting retained over the mRNA. And this, it is particular for the ORF1 only. Only at the ORF1 termination codon, after termination on the mRNA, there is a retaining of the 40S. How many percent? About the 50% of the ribosomes, they are going to be retained over the mRNA. And this 40S subunit which is written over the mRNA. Now it can go further, that is it will go into the ORF2 or it may go into the ORF3 or the ORF4 also, or it may go into the GCM4. Okay, but here before going towards the GCM4, in the ORF2 only, okay, in the ORF2 only, if it is getting the complex, the ternary complex, that is EIF2, okay, EIF2 with the methionine, with the charged tRNA, that is the charged tRNA with the methionine, this it is what, it is a ternary complex, EIF2 charged tRNA, this it is a ternary complex, and this ternary complex, it is, if it is getting bound to the 40S subunit in the ORF2 only, at the initial sites, at that time what will happen, there will be the scanning of the AUG codon, and after scanning of the AUG codon, ORF2 it is getting translated. Okay, but here, okay, here what will happen, at the termination, okay, at the termination there will be, okay, at the termination what will happen, there will be the termination of the translation, that is all the subunits, that is the 40S subunit, 60S subunit, then your charged tRNA, that is the tRNA, uncharged tRNA, and the peptide. All it is getting, all it will get dissociated from here, dissociated from the termination codon from the ORF2. That is, if the 40S, okay, if the 40S ribosome, 40S subunit of the ribosome, if it is entering into the ORF2, and if it is getting the ternary complex, then there will be the translation of the ORF2. If the ribosome, it is going to enter into the ORF3, 40S subunit of the ribosome, it is enter into the ORF3, and then if it is getting the ternary complex, then there will be the translation of the ORF3, and at the termination codon, there will be the termination, and all the subunits, they are getting dissociated, no retaining of the 40S. Same thing it is going to happen with the ORF4. Means, the ribosome, okay, the 40S subunit of the ribosome which is retained on the ORF1, that if it is reached up to the GCN4, if it is going to reach up to the GCN4, then and then there will be the translation of the GCN4. Otherwise, there will be no translation of the GCN4. Now, here, what will happen at a high concentration of the amino acids? When there is a high concentration of the amino acids, at that time the charged tRNA, okay, charged tRNA, it will be at a higher concentration. The met tRNA bound with the methionine, it will be at a higher concentration, and due to that, the EIF2, okay, methionine tRNA complex, it will be also in a higher concentration, that is a ternary complex concentration, it is also going to be the higher one. So here the ribosome, okay, the ribosome, okay, it will get the ternary complex easily, as its concentration it is a higher one, okay, and there will be the translation of the ORF1. Then this, okay, this it will get terminated, okay, this complex it will get terminated at where, at the termination codon of the ORF1. This 40S, it is 50% of the 40S, it is going to be retained over the mRNA. This 40S, it may enter into the ORF2, okay. Then if it is getting the ternary complex, then there will be the translation of whom? Then there will be the translation of the ORF2. And then there will be the translation of the ORF3, then there will be the translation of the ORF4. But the amount of the ORF translated, they will be at the lower levels. Because the number of 40S which are used into the ORF1, they will be lesser into the ORF2, then it will be lower into the ORF3, and then least it is going to enter into the ORF4. And a very minor amount it is going into the GCM4. Because all the ribosomes which are retained, the 50% ribosome, 40S ribosomes, subunit of the ribosomes which are retained over the ORF1, all they are not going to reach up to the GCN4, as the concentration of the ternary complex it is a higher one. So they are going and binding to the 40S subunit of the ribosome efficiently. So the ribosome 40S ribosome, they are unable to reach at the GCN4 at a higher concentration. That is, there will be the low level of the translation of the GCN4. This it is going to happen when the concentration of the amino acids, they are the higher one. So what will happen then into the lower level of the amino acids? Amino acids level, it is a lower one, charged tRNA, it will be the lower one. And here one thing more, it is what? Your ERF2, it will get phosphorylated, it will get phosphorylated due to the ERF2 alpha. ERF2 alpha, it is whom? It is kinase, and this it is also called as an GCN2. Okay, ERF2 alpha, it is going to do the phosphorylation of the ERF2, and the phosphorylated form of the ERF2, it is not efficient to get bound with the GTP. Okay, so here if there has to be the formation of the complex ERF2 charged tRNA, okay, that is the tRNA bound with the methionine. Okay, if this ternary complex, it has to be synthesized or it has to be formed, at that time this ERF2, it should be bound with the GTP. And this efficiency of binding of the ERF2 to the GTP, it is getting reduced when ERF2, it is getting phosphorylated. So at a lower level of the amino acid, these kinases, ERF2 alpha, which are the kinases, that is the GCN2, these kinases, these are getting activated and it is going to do the phosphorylation of the ERF2. So there is a presence of the form of the ERF2, which is a phosphorylated form of the ERF2. And this phosphorylated form of the ERF2, it is unable to get bound with the GTP. So here there will be the lower concentration. There will be the lower concentration of the ERF2 charge tRNA, that is the ternary complex concentration, it is a lower into the cell. Due to this, what is going to happen? What is the effect of it on the translation? Here, it is a 40S, okay? Then there is a binding of your ternary complex to the 40S. Then there will be the scanning, AUG codon, now it is getting scanned, it has been found out by the 43S complex. And then what is going to happen? Then there will be the binding of your 60S and complete translational unit, it is going to be formed. And now this, it is allowing the translation of whom? It will allow the translation of the ORF1. Now here at the termination, 40S subunit, it is going to be retained, okay, and this 40S, now it can go into the ORF2, but the concentration, it is how? It is a lower one. So there is a delay, okay, there is a delay of the ERF2 charged tRNA to get bound with the 40S. So this 40S, now it will go further, it may go into the ORF3, and in the ORF3 also it may happen that it is not getting whom? It is not getting the ternary complex. Or it may get the ternary complex, but there's some of the ribosomes which are behind, it may go travel further, it may go into the ORF4 also, and then it will go into the GCN4. Means this ERF2 charged tRNA ternary complex concentration, it is a lower one. As it is a lower one, they are delaying to reach up to the 40S. And during this period only, this 40S, it can reach up to the open reading frame of the GCN4. And as this 40S, it is going to reach up to the GCN4, and at this time, what will happen? The ternary complex, it may catch. Okay, it may catch the 40S. Okay, it may catch the 40S, which is present into where? Which is present to the GCN4, and then there will be what? Then there will be the translation of the GCN4. Okay, so when the concentration of the amino acids, it is a lower one, at that time there is phosphorylation of the ERF2, okay, by whom? By the ERF2 alpha, which is a kinases, and that it is also known as the GCN2. GCN2, it is going to do the phosphorylation of the ERF2. ERF2 in a phosphorylation form, it has a lower affinity for the GTP, so it is not getting bound with the GTP efficiently. So there is a lower concentration of the ternary complex, that is the ERF2 charged tRNA. It is in a lower concentration. So this 40S, which is retained into the ORF1, it can reach up to the GCN4, and there the ternary complex, it can catch the 40S subunit of the ribosome, and it can do the translation of the GCN4 efficiently. Okay, so in this way, at a lower level of the amino acid, the translation of the GCN4, it is at a higher level. At a higher level of the amino acids, at a lower level, there will be the translation of the GCN4. Okay, I think you may have understood this translational control. Okay, so if you have any doubt, if you have any comment, you can write down into the comment box. And also, if you have liked my videos, please subscribe my channel and also share my videos with your friends, so that the knowledge it is going to spread. Thank you.